She's Sally Kohn, you know her, the Fox News contributor, social activist, happy that gay people can finally enjoy the same right to get married as all of the rest of us. He's Congressman Tim Walberg, Republican of Michigan. He believes the Supreme Court's decision greenlighting gay marriage in California puts society itself at risk. I welcome both of you. Congressman Walberg, you first. How does Sally's marriage and the fact that she has a 4.5-year-old daughter with her partner put society at risk?
Well, I'm not so sure that that puts society's risk. I think the issue of DOMA and the decision does when we add another impingement upon making marriage the successful foundation point of America, making it continue to be successful. That's the issue. We're not saying that anyone should not be able to love who they choose or have relationships, but bottom line, the only way that you continue society is through a man and a woman having a child and then caring for that child appropriately. And that's my concern, that we have further challenged marriage from being that building block.
Sally?
In the congressman's district, not only are there gay families, there are single parents, there are grandparents raising their kids, and they are all entitled to the benefits and protections of the government the congressman represents, as well as heterosexual couples that have children, as well as those that don't. That's what we do in this country. We protect everyone. We give everyone rights equally.
I don't disagree with the fact that we ought to be giving each and every person equal rights under the Constitution. But that doesn't include redefining words that are very descriptive of a foundational structure of society that goes back to the beginning of creation, where a design was put in place that works very well. And in fact, it's the only design that produces children that carries on society. We ought to encourage that.
My child has two moms. She's doing pretty well. You know, I'm interested, though. I'm glad to hear the congressman say he supports equal protection because, in fact, as I know you know, Congressman, you have not supported the Employment Non-Discrimination Act, which would protect the gay people in your district as well as across the country from being fired because they're gay. Right now, legally, this is not adding rights. This is making sure that our existing laws are applied equally to everyone. And if you're so in favor of equal protection, why don't you, for instance, support something as simple as gay people shouldn't be able to be fired from their jobs?
This is not talking about equal protection. We're talking about redefinition, definition of a framework, a foundational point of society. That's what the DOMA issue was about. It was saying, listen, are we going to redefine marriage to put it in a place that it was never intended? It isn't the same. Women and men are complementary for a purpose. And the purpose is a great design, a design that continues society.
That's fair, but then let me ask you two questions. Why is it then that you allow elderly couples who can't have children to marry? And why also haven't you put forward a bill to ban divorce if you're so concerned with the preservation of marriage?
I think you bring up a good point. We have put many hurdles in the way of good marriage. One of those is no-fault divorce, but we're talking about DOMA today. And the Supreme Court got it wrong when they said that the states should be able to make up their own decisions, their own minds, their own laws.
So, Congressman, let me ask, you know, you're duly sworn to uphold the law and protect all the people in your district. You think that families like mine, two loving gay parents raising kids, not raising kids, should be legally treated as second-class citizens in your district?
Absolutely not. You are abiding by the law in my district. You have all of the rights of the law.
No, but we don't.
No, you do. You just don't have the definition of marriage.
Well, but sir, that means we cannot, that means there are over 1,000 federal benefits that you as a congressman are aware of, from tax benefits to the hospital visitation to immigration to Social Security inheritance, that my family does not have access to. Families in your district do not have equal access to.
Let's
and you're saying
those.
That we shouldn't because we're somehow lesser families.
Let's debate those issues, but not redefine marriage as a term, and not simply a term of art, a term of reality that goes back to the beginning of time.
Sir, it's a term of law, and what we're talking about here is civil marriage. We're not talking about marriage in churches, marriage in religious institutions, which each church, each faith group has the ability to decide on its own. We're talking about how our
sure.
government, that we all belong to, apportions legal rights and benefits to all of us, which it does using this little word called
and
marriage.
Of course,
hold on a second. on my radio program. And Sally, I'm glad that you come on. Congressman, I'd love to have you come on. The people who are most concerned about this movement suggest that now the floodgates will open. Now you'll have sister marrying brother. Now you'll have men demanding polygamous rights to marry multiple spouses. How do you answer that question, that once the door has been cracked, anything goes?
I mean, this is sort of crazy. This notion that, oh, all of a sudden now you can marry your dog. Well, in theory, I guess, under that theory, you could have married your opposite sex dog before, and now you can marry your same sex dog. I mean, this is ludicrous. This is not, and again, this is not about, you know, redefining anything. This is, we have a government that apportions certain rights and benefits in certain ways. And for instance, whether the congressman thinks it's the ideal or not, we give Social Security inheritance to grandparents raising their grandkids, to single parents. We recognize different kinds of families under the law.
Congressman, what were you get the last word? We're going to hell in a handbasket.
I don't think that's the case at all. There's not the issue of love here. There's the issue of society continuing on in a way that has worked, that is the best approach for a loving relationship of a son or a daughter with a blood relative called a mom or a dad, and a marriage that can only be defined that way, which is unique to society and continues it on. Let's also remember, for the best interests of kids, we ought to be willing to do the sacrifice that's necessary, and for the best interests and the needs of kids, we ought to make sure that we don't put in place the best interests and desires simply of adults that negatively impact kids.
Congressman Walberg, thank you. How's your kid doing?
My kid's doing great. Maybe someday the congressman can meet her and he can tell her that himself.
I wish her the best.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure you do. Thank you, Congressman Walberg.
Really
thank
do.
You, Sally.
Thank you.